Hour 2 of the Robert Christian Show, and greetings everyone. Wherever around the globe that you are, hey, we welcome you. Let's take a short look at the news headlines that we are following as in the second hour of today's show. We're going to be talking about the day that hell on earth could come, and could that be Sunday? What are they saying? And hey, will you be watching Skyward? What do you think? First, a look at some of the funnies. House Republican Speaker John Boehner will resign as Speaker and leave his seat at the end of October. NBC News has confirmed actually today. Boehner, harder, longer. He told the NBC News affiliate that the Speaker believes that putting members through a prolonged leadership turmoil would do irreparable damage to the institution. Okay, guess what? Well, John, wake up. Wake up just a little bit, because it's already done that. But he also says that he is proud of what his majority has accomplished as Republicans. And his speakership for the good of the American or the Republican Conference and the institution. But he will resign as the speakership. His sails are going to sail. His boat is going to have a hole in it. And his seat, he'll be leaving this, hooray, 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 effective October the 30th. Well, isn't that a little spiffy? Boehner has also been under prolonged pressure from conservatives and his own party, you say, who have accused him of failing to fight the Obama administration on issues important to the Republican Party. Let me get serious. Folks within his party have been pushing to oust him if he presented any legislation that would continue to fund the government and avoid a government shutdown without stopping the federal funding of Planned Parenthood. Can you say, oh, wah, 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 oh, wah, oh, wah? What else? The CEO of the controversial drug company, Turning Pharmaceutical, has announced that he intends to lower the price of the drug that is in question after it emerged this week that the company, which bought the patents to the decades-year-old drug back in August, had hacked its prices from $13.50 per pill to $750 per pill. Martin, the owner, hit the headlines this weekend when the New York Times carried a report on his company's astronomical price hike for the medication, which is commonly used to treat toxoplasmosis and malaria. Toxoplasmosis is a common parasitic infection that can prove fatal to those with compromised immune systems, such as those suffering from advanced HIV infection or perhaps even cancer. But he I guess tried to mend things up a little bit, and he told the Bloomberg that if you can't afford the drug, we will give it to you away free, especially for patients in need or who does not have the income. We will never deny someone the treatment for their inability to pay. What do you think of that? I'm Robert Christian. Stay tuned. Let's have fun.
You're watching The Robert Christian Show. We'll be right back. Stay tuned.
And we are in hour number two of the Robert Christian Show. Hello, everyone. Wherever that you are. Hey, we're going to be talking in this hour of all hell on earth breaking loose. And some people are saying, guess what? Hey, it could happen as early as Sunday when an eclipse happens, right? An eclipse. When, what's going to happen here? The moon is going to turn to blood. It's going to turn red. And suddenly it's going to disappear. And then suddenly. And then suddenly. That's a sign of the end of the age. The moon isn't going to shine. It's going to turn red. Then it's going to go away. Then it's going to come back. And then another day will happen. You know, and a lot of people, and to me it's sort of sad, because a lot of people, they take all of this, which is a natural occurrence. It's happened more than once. But it's been over 30 years since it has happened like this again until Sunday night. But you know what? A lot of people, they look at it and say, you know, oh, I've got to run in fear of this. Oh, things are going to go haywire. Ooh, the bad. You know what? Everything has got to be bad. Everything has got to be evil to the core. Everything is just bad all over. Really? Well, a lot of people are very frantic. They're looking at these signs of the times, and they're looking at this as if it is a disaster that is waiting to happen. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, for a historic standpoint, it would be interesting to be able to look up at the moon and to watch it in all of its glory, and to see it change, to see the Earth's shadow and the sun and the moon all line up perfectly over North America. Again, it has happened before. Now, having said that, why would people be running in fear? You know what? Any time, and I guarantee you, if this show was based on fear and not hope, suddenly there would be an awful lot of people that would in droves, right? Would come into the show and say, "Hey, yeah, let's watch this." More so than now. If it was based on fear and hate and horrifying events. And that's what we covered. But when you look at something brand new, and you look at the world that we live in, and you try at least to make a positive impact, a good influence on others that are around you to help to change the world that you live in, and try to make peace where there seems to be no peace. You know what? I love people like that. I love to be able to see a day in the world where people can get along, where people can rejoice, where people can be happy, where people can be who that they are, right where they are, feel loved, feel excited. Feel that the spirits that be, that the heavens above, the earth beneath us, are all here for a reason. And that maybe your voice, your single voice, can change the world. You know what? It can. So rather than to focus on what divides, people want to focus on what divides. But I would rather focus on what is going to unite us as people of Earth. I would rather focus attention on what is going to bring a common denominator where presently there doesn't seem to be one. There doesn't seem to be a time in a lot of people's lives that is dedicated, or at least enough time that is dedicated, to truth and equality and hope. People love the idea of hopelessness. You know, and it is sick. But they love it. They thrive on it. Well, we have to live in a hopeless society. We have to live in a hopeless world, and oh, the fun of it. Let's see the fun of this going on. Let's see really what time it is and really what's going on. You know, let's do this. Let's focus our attention on the bad, the evildoers, and not the peacemakers. Let's focus our attention on the bad and any creepy crawly thing that we can turn into fear and into a hateful situation. Let's do that because, hey, ratings will be great. You know what, folks? I could so easy turn the other cheek and tell people, you know what? God hates you. God despises you. Let me play the religious card. Or say, oh, you know, guess what? You know, God, you know, people shouldn't be gay. People shouldn't be lesbian or bisexual or transgender. People shouldn't do that because that's an abomination, you say. The fear, the torment, and then, oh, the moon is going to turn to cheese, into a red rock. And people are going to start living their life and in fear, so we have to endorse and support that fear. We have to prop that fear up. And not love, hope, tranquility, gentleness. Let's go the fear route, because, hey, that sells. Fear sells like sex does, and they both sell quite well. Look at the religious left, or the religious right. They love fear. And the more people that they can fearize or torment or terrorize based on their religious lack of understanding, perhaps. But the longer the people do this, you know what? The more millionaires that are going to be made, and the more stupid, dumbed down people are going to become. Folks, I don't want anybody to be stupid or dumbed down. I want people to be wise. I want people to wake up and smell the roses and say, you know what? There's another day. This is going to happen on Sunday, right? In the equinox, I think that's what they call it, where daytime and nighttime are equally divided, the equinox. That's what it's called, right? So we're going to look at this the beauty of it, it's going to be great. Are you going to watch it and be excited to see something? But oh no, people are more frantic over this. And I don't understand why. You know what they've said? That President Obama, oh, he was the Antichrist. Really? Well, that's what some people said. Some people look at religious leaders and, oh, that's the Antichrist. And these people have no idea what they're even talking about. You know, these seasonal Christians, they come out of the closet, typically maybe once a year, maybe twice. It depends on the world of politics and if there's a social thing going on that they perhaps may not agree with, then suddenly, oh, guess what? They're gonna do this, right? They're gonna start exercising this fear. Oh, good grief! You know what, ladies and gentlemen? Why would you want to live in fear? I don't get it. Some people enjoy it. Some people think, let's live in fear. We have to live in fear. We've got to be in fear. That's just the way that things rock and roll. We got to be in fear. But folks, you know what? I refuse. That's one thing about me that I refuse. I refuse to live in fear. Why should I? Why should you? Ladies and gentlemen, we are living in a very unprecedented time. In the culture of the world, we're seeing a lot of things happen. People are running frantic of Wall Street collapsing. People are running frantic about the world of politics. They're running in fear because of evildoers or whoremongers or warmongers standing behind the pulpit of a church on Sunday. And yet, they fail to understand. They don't want to understand that, you know what, greater things are happening to the world right now. And to me, it is explosive. It is immense. It is something fantastic. When you see the changes, we need to embrace them. We need to look at the changes and look at the world that we live in and ask yourself, hey, what can we do to make the world that we live in a better place? You know what? If it's your voice, if it is just your voice, if you seem to be the only one in the forest that is screaming and mandating around you peace and comfort, then be that one. You know what? People have given up on me personally for obnoxious reasons. But folks, I choose not to worry, because I'm not going to embrace those who have abandoned me, abandoned friendship, and maybe abandoned their own hope. Because guess what? There is hope. There is hope on the horizon. And you, like me, we need to excel in hope. We need to be looking for hope and for peace and not for hate and war. So why people choose to live in fear and not in faith, I don't know. Why is fear in media? Oh, well, we have to fear this. Really? Well, that's what they want. They want people to fear it. They want people to fear, you know, everything under the book, under the sun. They want you to fear it as if it is the world's worst secret. Fear. Hey, folks, there's more than what meets the eye. This is the Robert Christian Show, live in Washington. Visit us again online at robertchristianshow.com. We'll be back, ladies and gentlemen, right after this. Don't go too far. And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Robert Christian Show. Hey, it is great to have you all joining us. And visit us on the web at robertchristianshow.com. There is more to the show than what meets the eye. And, you know, I encourage everyone to do your part to make the world a better place and to have the vibrations of life going through you, going through your heart, the vibrations of life, of love, of hope, rather than feeling that you have nothing in this world to offer. I think everybody has something in life to offer. Everybody in life has something that they can do that is going to encourage, that is going to uplift, that is going to bless, and be an exciting factor. That's what I say. In people's lives. You know what? For me, the worst kind of a person that I could ever want to hang out with is somebody who is a deadbeat. Somebody who just wants to focus on the bad, the fear, the hate, the anger. Thank you, Jesus. All right. But they want to focus their attention on everything that's bad and not look at what is right. You know what? It doesn't take a brain scientist. It doesn't take a brain doctor to be able to look at the world that we live in and say, you know what? We can do better. Any idiot can say that. But it takes somebody with wisdom to say, you know what? I want to raise that frequency in my body. I want to raise this up around me. And I want to be an encouraging force. I want to look out at the goodness of the earth and the goodness in people and say, well done, let's do this thing together. Rather than saying everything in life is bad, everything in life is horrifying, everything in life is just what it is. No, it's not. It isn't. We need to wake up, ladies and gentlemen. Embrace change. Hope for something so vital, so crucial. Look for it, because it's there and it's coming. The world that we live, ladies and gentlemen, is a world that is fragmented by a lot of things. We look at our leaders, they're fragmented. Look at what they haven't done. They haven't worked for the American populace because it's fragmented. You look at a lot of marriages that have ended in divorce or soon to end in divorce, and relationships that have ended, friendships that have ended because of fragments. And too often, people focus their attention on the negative because that's what sells. If they can sell you a bill of goods based on fear, they did well. But I would rather sell people a bill of goods built on hope, trust, commitment, and a committed relationship than I ever would to sell them down the river and say, guess what? We have to do this because of fear. Put the fear factor in here and things are going to work just right. You know what? Again, folks, I could say, everything that I've stood for, everything that I've said in the last 30 years plus of being in media, that it was worthless. And let me suddenly change and go the other way. And you know what? I'm telling you what, I would bet you that the ratings of my live shows would go up. The YouTube channel would explode, really. The Facebook would be going off the wall. The Twitter would be going off the wall. The Instagram, I'm not on Instagram. That would be going off the wall. All this stuff going on. Because fear breeds fear. And it does. But ladies and gentlemen, I want to be centered. Not self-centered or self-righteous, but centered. It may be a little bit to the left of center. Because I still want to be close enough to look at both sides of the coin. Folks, isn't life about that? Isn't life about looking at both sides of the coin? Now, granted, not every argument you're going to win, but not everything in life is an argument. Sometimes what we need is hope, prosperity, the option, the opportunity to see things in a whole new light, to embrace change, to embrace your neighbor, not hate your neighbor. The world that we live in, folks, it is surely changing. People's minds are changing. The atmosphere is changing. I mean, you could just take a good deep breath and you can sense, use your senses, but you can sense a something brand new that is going on in the horizon. Something brand new is just around the corner. If you not just wait for it, but if you capture the moment. Folks, we must capture it. You know what? All of our lives and every moment of our life has led us to this very moment right now. Isn't that powerful? Isn't that interesting? Isn't that wonderful? That every moment of our lives have led us up to this very moment. So why would you want to sit back and argue? Why would you want to live your life in fear, knowing that for the last several years of your life that it has brought you to this moment? Folks, it has. Now, we are either going to argue about this very moment, or we're going to caress it, and we're going to hold on to it. Wow. Talking about a powerful message, and it is extremely powerful. What do you all think? This is the Robert Christian Show live in Seattle. Wow, we've got more to come, folks. Stick around. Use your social media, your Facebook, your Twitter. Wherever that you are, hey, we welcome you to the Robert Christian Show, and we'll be back right after this. Don't go too far. This is the Robert Christian Show. It is more than what you imagined. In the news, Tea Party Republicans are rejoicing at the news that House Speaker John Boehner will be resigning at the end of the month. Does that mean a complete gridlock until November of 2016? Good question. And we'll be getting into that on a future show. Life, of course, it is way more than what we ever would have imagined it to be. And I would encourage you, ladies and gentlemen, to use your social media, your Facebook, your Twitter. Let your friends know that we are on the air for today's show. You know, folks, the life that we live, it is a life, and it should be a life of hope, of dreams, of inspiration, to inspire to other people to be the best people that they can be, not to dictate or to mandate whom that someone can love, who that they should love, who that they should be in a relationship with, who they should not be, the church they go to, the school they go to, the car that they drive, or the neighborhood that they live in. But we should be who that we are. Now, having said that, ladies and gentlemen, this is a dangerous, very dangerous position. And I'm sure that you have seen people like this, where they become very cozy, very comfortable. Well, I'm comfortable. Bless God and Greyhound, I'm comfortable. You see, I have everything that I ever wanted. I have everything that I've ever dreamt. Those are dangerous people, I'm telling you. Because, folks, when we have become so comfortable in the world that we live in, this society, we are so comfortable with the job that we have, we better watch out. Because we're not growing. And ladies and gentlemen, growth is more than just the physical body. But growth is in the spiritual realm. Growth is understanding that central system that keeps you balanced. Growth is in your heart. Growth is in not just your bank account, but by the way that you live, the atmosphere that is around you. Is it positive or is it negative? Is the atmosphere around your job positive or negative? If it's a negative, change it to a positive. Folks, it's that simple. You can live your life for the rest of your life in fear, but you will miss a vital and a fantastic opportunity. I'm telling you. To explore yet a new horizon. You know, in media, it's funny. For me, it was. Because I really, looking back, I really did not choose media as a career. It chose me. I didn't choose to want really to be in the media. It just chose me, I guess. In kind of a weird way. But rather than to fight it, rather than to argue about it, well, I don't want to do this. You know what? I had to stop. I had to say, wait a second. Maybe I can do something with this. In life, it's the same thing. And it is. We can either go down a road of survivorship and be a survivor, or you can choose to live in fear and live your life as a victim. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't want to be anybody's victim. I want to be a survivor. I want to execute the best things that I can do in my life. I want to see the world. I want to be able to help somebody along life's journey, along life's path. And maybe in 50 years from now. Maybe in 100 years. Maybe then people will find some of the video archives or a news spread or whatever, and maybe then they'll say, who was this guy? You know what? I choose to live my life not in fear but in hope. I could fear a lot of things. I could fear my neighbor. I could fear going to the store. I could fear going to the gas station. I could fear going to the doctor. I could fear going to a hospital. I could fear fear itself. I could fear religious persecution. I could fear the right-wing fundamentalist. You know what? We could fear a lot of things, right? I choose not to. Folks, I don't want to be in a position where I have to defend every single thing in my life. But what is worth defending is worth holding on to. I want to hold on to what I do best, the best way that I can. I want to hold on to friendships, because in those friendships become relationships. And I want a relationship, not necessarily just a friendship, but a relationship, and a solid one, a good one. So in the event that things go south, in such of an event in my personal life, or in the life of my career, that I need a helping hand, that, you know what, I can get that help. Maybe it is one word that would be spoken in season. Listen to me. Now, I'm talking to somebody. Folks, if it is one word that is spoken in season, it is far better than 10,000 words spoken out of season. So why would you want to speak out of season? We should be speaking with love, with gentleness, with mercy in our heart, with a spring in our step. We should be able to laugh and to rejoice and just to be happy. Be who you are and be the best that you can be. And you know what? We can do that. You can do that. There is nothing in life like good laughter. And you know what? Speaking of, Monday's Skaya show. You know, I had a ball during that show. I did. It was quite energetic, quite funny. It was meant to be that way. It wasn't meant to be a stumbling block to anybody. But we talked about sex. We talked about something that a lot of people are very uncomfortable, shall I say, talking about. We talked about issues in relationships and drives and thrives and things that go bump in the night. It was kind of educational and kind of funny at the same time. But you know what, folks? It showed me this. And it did. It showed me this. Pay attention. That, you know what? Everything in life doesn't have to be so serious. Sometimes what we need to do is break down the barrier. We need to break down the wall and stand up and say, wait a second, around here. Up again around here. I'm not afraid. I am not afraid to laugh. I'm not afraid to be happy. I'm not afraid to see success. You know what? There are people. I don't know. Maybe you're one of them. That you're afraid of success. You're afraid of going forward because of going backwards. Maybe you're afraid of taking that step out of your comfort zone, out of that box. Maybe you're afraid of it. And maybe you feel that, well, I can't do it. I just can't do it. I can't go forward. I'm afraid of fail. You know what? For me, failure is not an option. And I've always had that motto. It's not an option. I have to succeed. I want to succeed. I want to do things in life that are going to bless and encourage, help and strengthen my fellow human beings. And that's a pretty tall order. Folks, as a talk show host, I can't say that it is all fun and games as always. No. Sometimes it is. Sometimes it is kind of comical. When I look at the world, though, I can look at it with fear and hate or love and hope. And I prefer to look at people with hope and love, gentleness, and with a heart that says, yes, 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 we can do this thing together. And you know what? We can. Now, granted, I know that people are not going to agree with me on everything. And I can't expect them to do so. But I think that one thing that we can agree on is life does change things. Time does change things. Our heart grows, our spirit grows, our mind grows. But if we ever neglect the gift that is within you, in that center, that pivoting moment, that element in your life that keeps you steady, that keeps you balanced, if you ever negate it, if you ever neglect it, that's going to cause a lot of harm, more harm than it would good. So things in your life, you could be going through a divorce, you could be going through a separation, you could be going through an anxiety complex. You could be going through a lot of things in life. I've gone through a lot of things in life. I still go through a lot of things in life. As I'm just a human being, just like you are. I'm not going to appear to be something or someone that I am not. That's not my style. But to say to you that when you look at each other in the heart, you look at each other in the eyes, you look at each other in the spirit, massive things can happen. And I would prefer for people around me to understand me, not judge me, not hate me, not be so aggravated at me for whatever that their reason is, but to be accepting of who I am, just like they would want me to be for them. We're going to take a short break, folks, and we'll be back with more of the Robert Christian Show as we get ready to wind up the show. Time for relaxation, a time of hope, a time of peace. We need understanding, mercy, and gentleness. In the world that we live, there is an awful lot of war. There are an awful lot of people who profit off of the backs of others. We've seen Wall Street collapse. We've seen the stock market collapse. But what really matters is what's going on with you? What's going on with me? What's going on in the world that we live? Ladies and gentlemen, this is a challenge. Look up. I'm Robert Christian. live from Washington, The Robert Christian Show. Online, robertchristianshow.com. It is great to have you all with us today on this edition of The Robert Christian Show. It's more than what you imagined. We're focusing on something positive. We're focusing attention on issues that do matter. And you know what, folks? I would encourage you to do the same thing. You know, we can look at, of course, in the news, I look at it frequently. News feeds, news wires, live streams around the world. And a lot of times what I see is a lot of anger, a lot of frustration. I can understand that. I can understand why that people are angry. Absolutely. But anger, it is an effect of what had happened. It wasn't the cause necessarily. And we need to keep that in check. We can protest a lot of things in this life, trust me. But one thing that I will say absolutely for certain is this: that we can learn from each other, we can learn from each other's mistakes, and we can push forward. Or we can remain in a rut and be in fear of everything and everyone. That choice is ours. Wow. Hey, folks, reminding you of upcoming shows. Let me get out my little mighty schedule. The mighty calendar. Wow. Upcoming. Marilyn Redmond, an author, is going to be coming on. Very good. We're going to be talking with her on the 9th. David Pesora, an attorney at law, is going to be coming on the 23rd. Hooray! He's been on the show before, David Pesora. But we're going to be talking specifically on that show, that day, on the issue of domestic violence. And, you know, a lot of people live with domestic violence. They live in a very volatile situation at home. I don't know. Maybe you're one of them. If you are, or you know somebody that is, I would encourage you to tune into that show, October the 23rd, with David Pesora. And then in November, we have, and I'm going to love this, the liberal redneck. Joe is coming on the 6th of November. Lovely. That's going to be a lot of fun. Fred Greiger is coming. Also fantastic. He's a book author. But we're going to be talking about financial advising. You know, he's going to be talking about eminent domain when it comes to land, when it comes to ownership, and what is actually going on that front. So that's going to be a very interesting show, to say the least. We have had shows in the past on off-grid living. Tiny houses. You know what? I still like that idea. I do. If you can buy a plot of land, get a tiny house, mini house thing, get it set up, you know, live that way, off the grid, completely, you know, self-contained. I think that's great. That's marvelous. And a lot of people these days are looking into that. They're looking into to building their homes green. I mean, it's amazing, building homes underground, building adobe homes. You know, it's amazing. So is that the new fad? You know, I would have to say it is. It is. But just because somebody would live off the grid doesn't mean that their life as they know it is going to cease to exist. But no. By any part of your imagination. No. But you know what? A lot of people, the closer to the earth I think that people are and that they get to giving back to the earth, to living green and to doing things that way, you know, I think that they live a healthy and very happy and very productive life. If I can say so, I think so. Off-grid living. We've done shows about that. Back in the day, Joy Shane, he was our co-host. He did a short series on off-the-grid living, building tiny houses to farming, planting and growing your own food and living off the land. And you know, it was an amazing show. And at least he had the guts to stand up and say, you know what, hey, this is a good idea. And you know what? He was right. But, you know, he's not the only one. A lot of people are wanting to live off the grid and saying, you know what, I'm tired of living in structures the way that they are. And I'm tired of not being able to plant and have my own domain. And so a lot of people are. So is that a new fad? Well, I don't know. That would be a really good question for Simon. Is it a fad, or would you consider it a way of life? Because it's two different things. A fad will come and go, but a way of life, it seems like that is a forever commitment. What do you think, folks? Wow. You know what? We have to be committed. Yeah, we got to be committed. Yep. We need to be committed to truth, to equality, to love, to peace, to hope. A lot of things. And you know what? We can do that. Absolutely. You know what, folks? We are nearing the end of today's show, and I hope that you can walk away with it with something. The first hour of today's show, I had to poke fun at John Boehnert, because he's a Republican. He's one of those people. He's kind of one of those people that, you know, you'd want to maybe see him from a distance. Maybe the further, the better. I don't know. But anyway, John Boehnert, here he is quitting. No longer going to be the Speaker of the House. Wow. You know, I really wonder, though, about Mitch McConnell, because now it's going to appear like Mitch, he's going to be there all by his little lonesome self. But not saying that that there's nobody else in the Republican Party. But you know what? What's funny, though, when it comes to the world of politics, this is a funny. Come on, a funny thing happened when a Republican got voted into office by a Democrat. Now that's funny, is it? I think that's a mistake. I do. Because you know what? Historically, the polls in politics, they changed. Because the Republican Party was what the Democratic Party used to be. And now the polls have changed. Kind of odd, isn't it? Nonetheless. No, I'm not. Trust me, I'm not happy at all with what's going on in Washington. And I'm not convinced that our vote as the American populace, that it is our vote that is really going to matter. I don't think so. I haven't thought that way in years. But going beyond the world of politics, yes, I laugh at it. I poke fun at it sometime. I imitate them. I just don't want to be them. But you know, folks, I do it with a clean heart, with an open mind, to say, you know what, we can have fun. Although we're talking about the world of politics, if that's what it is, or the world and all of its evils, and that's what it is, the world of religion, and we've had many shows about that. If it's issues about HIV and AIDS, then I've done many shows about that. If it is meeting lawmakers and having lawyers on, people running for the office of governor. And we had somebody that was running for the office of governor in California that came on the show. You know, if it is a reality TV host, TV star, that you know, hey, we've had some. If it is a director of a movie, we've had a director of a movie on. You know what? I'm like, great, let's have fun. Folks, there's a lot of things in life that we can have fun with. And we can. We all can laugh. We all can rejoice. And perhaps look at things a little bit differently. I want to do that, and I want you to as well. And reminding you all that the live shows for the Robert Christian Show are live every Friday at 3 p.m. Pacific right here. And we have a lot of content that is up on YouTube. Our website is full of a lot of content. You can visit us on Facebook. Follow me on Facebook if you'd like. And, of course, on Twitter. So, you know, yeah, there's a lot of things that we can do. We are everywhere. We're all over the place. Yes. And oftentimes during off hours of the show or off days, I'm airing something in here or doing work for an upcoming show. You know what? We have upcoming stuff, and I want you to be a part of that. I do. And as a last note, ladies and gentlemen, before we say hasta la bye-bye for another week here on the show, if you would like to help us to stay on the air and to help us to cover some of the expenses and upgrades that are necessary for us to keep going doing live shows, please feel free to send your donation via PayPal to robert@robertchristianshow.com. And all gifts, everything that comes into us, helps us to stay on the air. So, folks, I want to know what is on your agenda, your mind for the rest of this week. You know, we're getting ready, of course, for great things happening this weekend. Don't forget the super moon coming and the, what do they call it? Now my mind is a blank. It is completely a blank. The eclipse. Yes. That's upcoming. I think it's Sunday. So are you planning on watching the eclipse? You know, I don't know that I will. I don't know if we can see it. Well, maybe if we can see it, perhaps. But I'd go to, like, I think it's NOAA.gov. They have a timetable on there where you can expect to see that event take place in your area. If you're in North America, Europe, or I believe South America can see it, I think it is. Or, yeah, I think it's South America. Anyway, folks, hey, this is the Robert Christian Show. Love you. We'll see you next time right here for The Robert Christian Show. Don't forget, visit us online at robertchristianshow.com. And good night, wherever that you are.